Good morning children. Today we are going to do some exercises of practical life. It is that shelf in which you do your pouring. You've seen, right? You come and do your pouring activities. We are using the sponge and transferring water, threading beads. You remember that corner? Yes. From that corner or that shelf, I'm bringing these box of napkins. You know, this is a napkin, a cloth like a kerchief. Okay, I'm going to show you how to fold this napkin. Come take a look. See how I'm going to take this napkin into my hands and bring it to my table. When I bring it, I have to put it on my palm and put a finger on it, so that when I walk and come to my table, it will not fly away. I then place it on my table like this. I'm going to use both my fingers of this hand and this hand and open it. Smoothen it out. Now you watch how I'm going to close it. I'm going to bring this all the way till here. I have to smoothen it out. Now using my two fingers, I'm going to fold it like this. Smoothen it out. That's all. This is how you fold your napkin. After you have finished it, you have to put it back into this box. See how I'm taking and putting it? I took it in my palm. I'll go to the box and place it like this. Exercise of practical life is the most basic practice that you have to give to your child. The child is watching you do a lot of things at home. From the time it wakes up to the time he or she is going to sleep, the child is watching you do a lot of things. And a child learns to do those things by copying it. So you have to give an opportunity to copy whatever you are doing. So now I just showed them how to fold a napkin. They would have seen you folding big clothes. So asking them to help you to fold big clothes could be a big difficulty for them. So we must help them to feel, you know, very confident that I too can do it. For that purpose, you have to arrange some small napkins like this, or maybe a kerchief also to begin with. There could be daily at least some two or three napkins or kerchiefs which are coming after the wash. You can ask the children how to fold it, and when and always acknowledge their contribution that they have helped your family today. This is a very good feeling for the child, because everything that the child is doing is to ensure that they are also accepted as a member of your family, and their contribution is also as valuable as you are. You would have always noticed that whatever action you do, they will immediately copy that. Whatever words you use, they will immediately use it without any difficulty. They will be able to do it. So when we put it to productive things like this that we do at home, like pouring water into glasses, putting back things into the sink, or keeping the table clean, if they are watching all these things, ask them to help you in doing these chores at home and give them their opportunity by giving them things which are of their size. That will be the most, because it gives them a better grip on their hand, and they will also learn how to master it. with bigger things which are out of their size, the bounds of their size, there will be a greater challenge for them. But if you give things which are of their size, which fits into their hands with the weight which they can handle, then you will notice that they will do repeatedly and they will learn to master that particular action. So kindly do this. Any simple activities that you do at home, they allow them to do. And grandparents are the best way to bring in the cultural things that we have at home, the old things that the traditional things which I am talking about. Grandparents are very good at instilling those habits in those children. So allow them to observe the people in the house and give them an opportunity to do the exercises of practical life. I'll meet you all in another video. Bye.